Greetings from CNS and welcome to this new episode of NTB Dialogues, a special CNS series presenting insightful and thought-provoking interviews with leaders to accelerate progress towards ending tuberculosis. This series underpins the urgency to step up the fight against ending this pandemic. 193 countries have promised to end tuberculosis by 2030, while India has promised to end it by 2025. However, the latest Global TB Report of 2019 shows that the world is not quite on track to meet all the NTB strategy targets. New and fresh thinking is vital to reimagine every critical cog in the wheel to end TB and also to accelerate progress towards other sustainable development goals. Today's episode of NTB Dialogues features a very special guest, Mr. G. Swami Reddy, Project Officer at Lepra Society Office in Hyderabad. It is frontline leaders like Mr. Reddy who are really spearheading the fight against tuberculosis at the ground level. Welcome, Mr. Reddy, to our show. And can you tell us what has gone right? You have been involved with leprosy care and now with TB care and control. So since when have you been involved with this? And how have things moved forward? What has gone better? What has improved over the years? And where do we need to do better also?
Thank you, madam. Yeah, actually, we are started leprosy work in 1989. Then moved to TB work in 2002. In established 5 designated microscopies under in Hyderabad under RNTCB guidelines. There is a scheme for tuberculosis in RNTCP. According to the guidelines, we have put 5 lab technicians and running 5 designated microscopy centers. And it is better now, like earlier, there is a very less staff in tuberculosis diagnose centers and all those. Now, okay, it is better. And somehow we have to improve the diagnostics and we are getting more MDR cases also. And grassroots level also, we are bringing the patients. And we have good network with the private doctors and we have strengthened them also now. And every year we are doing World TB Day. In the day also, we are creating awareness among TB. Nowadays, it is better.
Okay. In fact, I have had the opportunity of visiting one such designated microscopy center. I've just returned from there. And I'm really amazed at the work and the coordinated manner in which the work is being done, all under one roof, people coming to get tested, microscopy testing for tuberculosis. They are being tested for HIV, for diabetes, and also an X-ray is being taken, and it's being done in a very, very, very methodical manner. That is what impressed me there. And also maintaining the records. For the first time, I saw that the Nikshe table on the tablet where all data was being recorded. So, Swamiji, what are the challenges which you face at the ground level, again, to just step up this fight against TB regarding diagnostics, treatment, treatment completion, and also the role of counseling, or do we need more counseling at that level? Can you just explain that?
Okay, madam. Counseling level, I think little bit reduced. Why? Because the health visitor, they have to visit the houses of patients. And nowadays they are providing 500 per month. And the concentration, I seen 2 or 3 DMCs, the concentration on only accounts, means what is the account number, Xerox copy of account number and Aadhaar number, and all they are collecting, but little bit reduced this counseling. First, they have to counsel the patient. how you came, what happened, what is the symptoms, and all those they have to see. And the lab technician also, they have to see first the sputum, correct sputum quantity, quality, and also they have to check out. Otherwise, the patient will give sputum and they will keep the other side, they will go away. Then later, the lab technician will see the sample is very less. It is very difficult to diagnose in TB process.
What about that? I saw there's diabetes testing is also going on. So are you coming across a lot of TB diabetes cases, and how is diabetes testing impacting TB treatment, or how is it helping in that? Because I saw there while I was there at the center that some very young patients are testing for that means positive for diabetes.
Yeah, this is also very important. Why? Because if the patient have diabetes, it is the cure rate is very less. Before that, we came to know the diabetes status, then only they will take diabetes treatment and they will take treatment for TB. That is good. Even we are doing now, in earlier also, just like 5 years back also, we did one study, diabetic TB. By that, we are tested for all TB patients for diabetic. Near about 10% of the people, they know diabetic only that time only. Before, they don't know their diabetic status. We purchased that AcuCheck and all those. We provided each DMC one. We have 5 DMCs. 5 DMCs. We have provided each DMC one diabetic check. Every individual patient we tested. Before some people, that 10% of people, they don't know about their status. Only we did the diabetic test. Then only they came to know they have diabetic. Because of that, they are taking diabetic treatment as well as TB treatment. Then only they will cure quickly. Otherwise, they prolong and they will relapse, and they will the treatment also not completed because of the diabetic.
How are you involving the private sector in TB care and control activities? Because a lot of our patients in India, they first normally they go to a doctor in the private setup. So how are you involving them?
Actually, we started the private practitioners involvement 10 years back, not now. 10 years back, just we started like a pilot project. We taken data from actually the people from slums and middle class also, they will go to the private doctor first time. The family doctor or private doctor, they will direct go to the private doctor. We taken data and we map up the private practitioners in our 5 DMCs area. And we sensitized them. One day workshop, we called them, we are sensitized them about TB and referrals, and they are referring many cases. That also we taken MBBS doctors, MB doctors, and physicians, and private practitioners, all we divided, and I presented one paper in one conference also. It is very good interaction. Otherwise, first involvement of private practitioners is very important and very good worked out in our DMCs area. They are sent many patients, and we kept as a dot providers also. Same in the doctor, they will refer one patient and we will provide the treatment for 1 week, and we keep the dot boxes in their places only. There are many doctors also our dot providers in earlier days. Now also we are continuing their services, and every year we will organize World TB Day event. In that event also, we are selected best doctors, best patients, best lab techs also. That is some kind of encouragement. Then only they are involved in our 5 DMCs. The PMPs network is good in our 5 DMCs.
You are also involving, I believe, political leaders and local leaders in this fight against TB, because political commitment is very important. So can you share some of the local actions at the local level, how you are involving?
We also involved in community involvement is very important in tuberculosis. Whenever we will visit the field, we will meet the corporators, sarpanch in rural, in the sarpanch and all those. They are also sent many patients, and we gathered one place and we eat the same World TB Day time. In the time of World TB Day, we are encouraged many leaders also. Some of the leaders, relatives also, they referred us, they diagnosed TB, they taken treatment also. In one patient in Gadyanaram, there is a big slum, small, just a story. Mm-hmm. And he came to us, he diagnosed his brother, one leader. He is an auto driver. He came to us, he diagnosed TB, taken treatment for 1 month. Then only they got reactions. In that time, reactions very severe. And his brother came, he's a leader, his brother came and what you did, my brother is such a healthy person. You provided treatment, what treatment you provided? But he is very serious. Then only we counseled him, and his brother also cured. Now, very good network with them. And he is referred every month 2-3 cases from their community, their slum. It is like in any program, community involvement is more important.
Yes, you are right. And also sharing the success stories, the treatment success stories will actually bring in more patients and sort of rebuild their confidence that TB is curable, treatable. So that is important. Mr. Reddy, what do you suggest? What is the way forward? How can we improve? And because India has just 75 months left to end TB, and we are not near the finishing line. So according to you, what needs to be done better, and how can we improve TB care in country?
Madam, just before I told, before it is very neglected. Now we are even political commitment also there, and leaders also there, corporators, and even we are involving in the rallies and all those. And people should know, first we have to go to the people, ground level, we have to sensitize them. And what is the facts about the tuberculosis? Many people still they are confusion, and still they are stigma about TB. But nowadays, very good medicineers came. We only 6 months they have to take that message to go into the community level also, not the peripheral. We have to organize many camps and many self-help groups, Asha, Sanganwadis, and all the health staff, stakeholders. We have to involve many people. Then only we can success what we achieve. We have to achieve.
Is there any awareness or information about latent TB infection in the public or even in the medical setup here? TB which is latent, but it can convert into active TB. Is there?
It is. Even though private doctors also they don't know. Recently they came to know that MDR TB. That's all. Previously they know only TB. TB means only cough. That they know, but latent TB, I don't think many people, they don't know. Nowadays, only MDR, even though we are organizing any sensitive program, private practitioners, then we are telling that about latent TB and MDR TB. But latent TB, it will take time.
Your city is holding the 50th Union World Lung Health Conference. It is about to begin in 2 days' time. So, what is your message for that conference? You are working, you are leading the fight from the ground level where the action is actually, because a lot of decisions are taken at the high level. But it is people like you who are really the implementers, who are implementing it and seeing the problem. So what is your message?
More involvement should be there. And NGOs involvement also very important for this such a disease, even leprosy, TB. The NGOs schemes also there. But many NGOs, they don't know what is the schemes which is which scheme eligible. That is NGOs important. NGOs involvement is important.
Thank you. Friends, you were listening to Mr. Swami Reddy, Project Officer at LEPRA Hyderabad. Thank you very much for being with us today.
This interview was part of the NTB Dialogues, a special CNS series presenting thought-provoking and insightful conversations with leaders to accelerate progress towards ending tuberculosis. Be welcome to share your comments or reflections on this NTB Dialogue series at www.citizen-news.org. Thanks for listening and stay tuned for our next episode of this series.